Hey guys, super stoked about everything, you know. I posted a couple things on Instagram this morning. I post videos on Instagram, little 60-second vignettes, if that's what you call them. Anyway, so make sure you're following Instagram. I use that more than YouTube, honestly. Sometimes when I just don't have the energy or time to take out the camera, I'll do a 60-second Instagram, keep you guys all updated. All right, what I'm doing right now, I'm finding the rattle, a really bad rattle in this passenger side. And I just found it, so I decided I'd go get my camera and let you guys all in on it. So when I was driving, I always hear something over here. And my ear direction just kind of always pointed to the pillar rather than the door. You know, the door I have dynamatted, listen to that. That's thud. That is solid. All dynamite in there. Then I started tapping here, and I got a big tap, a really big tap. And then, so I pulled this off, and I didn't see anything strange here. I do have all my green clips and stuff. And then with this out of the way, I tested this top half here. That's the rattle I've been hearing. Boom! And you probably can't see, but I know that they took that. Oh, I'm in the sun. Can't get you a good light. I know they took that piece off because the screw down there that I know you can't see. The screw down there has scrapes on it because they did the headliner, and this came off. So there's something. Let me show you real clear. A real big rattle. Right here. So I don't know how this stuff, maybe this, I don't think this is attached to the freaking, huh? Yeah, I mean, I just got to figure out how to get the stuff off. I guess I'll try taking off that bolt. I hope it doesn't cause me a problem. And I'll take out this little 10 millimeter down here, find out what that really bad rattle is right there. That's the last thing I need to fix for the body work type of stuff. Other than that, the headliner's quiet. Everything looks good. I'm really, actually really enjoying the paint job now, guys. I mean, everything's kind of changed. You say like, well, oh, I think that's just gunk. Yeah, that's not good. That's not a chip. That's just some tar and stuff I gotta clean off. The paint just is really amazing. When I rub it off, it just gets so crystal clean everywhere. It just feels thicker in some weird way. Get the light out. It feels thicker. I don't know. The bumper is just so, it feels strong, the paint. And who knows? I think it is. So let me get to that dash thing, show you what I found. Oh, I forgot about this. Fuck it, it's all scraped up, I knew it. Oh, this is the one I gotta paint. This is the one I gotta repaint, because I got some chips. So, this was my front grill, right here. And it's this nice 3D. And you saw, I mean, I saw yesterday that, like, this edge was like 1 to 2 millimeter, not even touching the grill. I went, oh, dang, I can't have that. It was like, it looked like it was hanging off on the edge. Look at that. So, of course, I took it off to investigate. I peeled off all the tape. And then I was kind of thinking, I kind of really like the uniqueness of my tinted OEM badge, 35% tint. And I kind of thought, I might want to go back to that because it was such a tough look, in my opinion. Just all the blacked out Road Warrior style is kind of how I look at it. I may retint it, because you can see tiny little chips in the tint. But then again, that's just to protect it. It doesn't really matter. But so then I said, okay, well, this is a pretty cherry frame here that came with a new one. So I said, I'll just pop it in here and be done. It is a different size frame. So I have to use my original Subaru frame. And then we get back to the problem, and it's a chip. So I have to repaint this original Subaru frame and put that, if I want to go tint, or if I don't, I could go this, but the problem is the tape doesn't hit the JDM grill and it doesn't hold this tight. Now it's probably the same thing over here. I just don't get it. Unless this is slightly different variances on this aftermarket crap and it doesn't fit as well, but I don't think that's the issue. So it's very strange that the tape just doesn't reach the grill properly on these for the front grill one. Anyway, I'm working on some grill stuff too. All right, guys, I'll show you what this thing is about. Your seatbelt adjuster. No screw behind the SRS. This is the B pillar, the middle pillar. You got your A pillar in the front, B is in the middle, and C is the one by your back window, just for anybody that might not know that yet. And it has one clip that's super tight and one bolt down here. That's all it has. And this is for the rubber trim. That's all that is. The rubber trim kind of slips into these slots. So as I expected, the noise is the slider unit. So I need to find some way to insert something or other in here and figure out how to tighten this up in some way. Now I think, see, there's a bolt back there. Let me check the other one. I don't know, it's similar. No, it doesn't rattle as much at all. This one has a really tinny type of thing. I think it's not connected properly myself. So I'm just figuring out, and you can see here, it's cool. You got different fork levels of your seatbelt adjustment. Now you see where it works. You pull it out, you click it. Pull it out, click it. Pull it out, click it. Sort of like that. But I have to figure that out right there. And actually, just to be super comfortable, I'll take out the two bolts, take this right off, and work at it in the convenience of my own workshop instead of out here. Now see, you have retainers on the back of your bolts here, so you're not going to lose your bolts really. You have your washers, everything's there where it should be. So I just got to figure out, like, see this bolt here. I wonder if they got to it somehow and if I need to tighten it a hair more to stop it from, well, it'll be kind of hard to test here. Hold on. I want to take these out to avoid any incorrect rattle noises. Just unscrew your retainers and put those right there. And now I can really do something to this here. Let me get you a really good light on that. So somehow figure out what's going on with that. And I know you have to be able to get to this bolt somehow, this bolt back there. Hold on. All right, so then this piece just actually snaps off really easily over that. So we're getting down a little bit closer. Interesting. Okay, I figured it out. So you twist and slide. Slide it out. See, those rings go under this lifter. So then what you have is this right here. That's the pin. Ooh, that pin goes in good. Let me, how do you do this? Let me see. Hold on. The pin goes in further up here. Let me see if it goes in. That's a tricky problem. It isn't a bolt you can tighten up, you know? But I mean, it definitely wasn't like this before. Just stuff that happens when you kind of modify cars, when you pull everything apart, that's all. So I'm trying to think. All I need is, between this slider, I need some kind of buffer between these two moving pieces so it just is tighter. So that's what I'm going to figure out. nice and tight, snug fit. Each side for extra security. Really tight, hard to push in without bending it, which is good. That's what you want. I mean, you want it nice and tight if it's gonna work right. Not very good yet. My noise is coming from somewhere else. I keep having a hard time telling if in the sunlight's better. I guess it is, but it's a little bit bright. So I finally I think I know what it is. It isn't the sliders. It isn't up here. And your seat belt goes into this nut, right? Into that nut, but it doesn't come out the back to secure it. So what you have here is the back of the nut hitting the plate. If I hold my thumb right here, that's it. All I need to do is slide something in that crack in there to stop that nut banging. And that'll do it. You can't take this apart anymore. It has pins. You can't slide it out. And it has a blocker nip there. So this is the deepest you can pull it apart. The problem is the back of this thread hole slamming against this metal for vibration. Insert something under the back of that. You should be good. All right, guys. Anyway, if any of you want a business card, just for whatever reason, I'll throw one in the mail for free. I mean, of course, nobody really has a need for them. I finally figured this out after doing all kinds of different methods and tapes to get this working right. Let me pull it up and get it to a better position here to show you. So I found something here. So you can't put it in this slot here because the nut goes deeper than that. The nut goes, see, it's a deep nut. It goes past that. So you have to put it on this and watch this come in under the nut. What did I do? Let's see. Oh, I have to adjust it up. Hold on. All right, so see that hole down there? If I slide this in, see how that does? It provides a buffer under there. Now, I might double thick it to get it extra strong. And then that in the hole is stopping that rattle and that bolt from hitting this panel right there. Okay, guys, I had an even better idea. Heat shrink tubing. It's a rubbery material. I cut it to the same size as that paper, which of course wouldn't last as long. And I just cut out a perfect piece of tubing there, which will slide right up the middle channel there. And it'll even lock in place on this little nub. And I might even go longer on that if I can go to the full size. And then it just locks in place between these, and it's always a buffer. Now you can't even fit two of these. It's such a fine fitment. You just kind of bend it. It's too tight to get in two thickness. So I can get in one thickness on this probably. This worked really good. Let me show you. Compared to the stock one, it's about the same now. It was a huge, huge metal slam before. And see, when I clip this in, this thing even clips here. So I'm going to do a couple padding strips somewhere here for this against this to stop the final rattle. And I'll see, let me see if I have a rattle on that one here. Not so bad on the driver's side, but I don't want to pop it in again. But this one had a big rattle tapping in here when it was reassembled. So I'm just going to do a couple sweet Noco Dynamat strips at very careful places here somewhere to just get this tight, and then we're done. All right, I'll just show you before I buckle it all up. Sweet strip right there, where all this kind of pushes against it just to try and get rid of that extra little play and just tighten everything up. I got to stop you again and show you something different. This isn't actually the hitting point, these two pieces. It's this piece to the metal. I'll move this out of the way. Right there. So all you need is some Dynamat right under that point. Just, let's see. Just lift that up and put dynamat under there. That is the key. And I'm starting to wonder if that was my whole rattle after all and not that. But either way, I'm glad I took care of that. So for sure, I want to put it right under this piece now. I'll probably take this piece off one more time because it's super easy. And so I can pull this off and put a perfect piece of dynamat right across the whole pillar, put it back together. That should do it. Just like that, and especially wraps around the edges where all this stuff bangs here. So you won't be able to tell till I put it back together if it indeed worked. I may even electrical tape these little clips down on the lower ones. They're a little loose. I may tape those up too. Remember that white clip on my toolbox? So at least we know that these are green on the pillar, so it's not a missing pillar clip. I still think it's a door panel clip, although I have no rattles, so it doesn't really matter. Let me roll this. Well, actually, I won't roll it in this case because I want it thicker. You know, I don't want to flatten it out. I want as much as possible. So this should definitely take care of it. I cut out the circle for the bolt. Let's try it out. And the process continues. Now a huge rattle is nothing else even attached, see? It's this piece right here. This is your belt slider. It goes into these little slots. And I have to, this is, seems like the biggest one of all. Doesn't even relate to any of the other stuff. So you just lift it past this hump right there and slide it right out. So I just gotta look at some options on this, some felt tape. Ooh yeah, my BMW felt tape, probably you'll do a good job on that. So what you have here is this ridiculously expensive Tesa tape used for BMW rattles, and they put it on a lot of their connection points. This was BMW dealer bought, actually, and it's like $30 or something, maybe more, but I've had this for years. It lasts a long time. So what I did, I'm going to put strips right there, see, under the sliders to give total isolation, and I'm going to, of course, trim it here, so because this part would be visible, so I'm going to trim it back on the outside and see how that works. Okay, I finally got it. Now what I had to do was triple layer the tape. I'll just show you since I have it out and it's the only opportunity I'll have. Oh, it comes out the bottom, of course. Ah, my nail is all screwed up. So I triple layered it. The only way to get it tight enough. And then, like it should, it takes pressure to get it under there and slide it all the way up until it's past, until it's past the nub. Oh, I missed a slot up here in all the slots. And pretty much totally gone now because of all that felt, making this piece a lot tighter. All right, guys, that was like an hour for one B-pillar, but I just want to show you the result. I haven't even really compared it myself yet, but I want to try it. So we got driver's side, which has not been done, and right here is where we're focusing on. Let me get you a proper light. Is that worse? That's kind of worse. You know where we're focusing, right here. There it is. It isn't too bad like the other one was, even stock. The other one had an issue. So let's look at the other one now. It may not be different if I just made it back how it's supposed to be, matching the driver, or it may be quieter. Let's see, passenger side. A little more solid, definitely. I have felt all kinds of places, every little, let me just show you real quick. Even though I put it back together. A fly?
A fly.
See, these plastic pieces. These plastic pieces have two layers of felt on top of them between the metal and the plastic here too. And, oh, you can see one more clearly there. There's felt all kinds of places. But bottom line, I'm sure that'll take care of most, if not all, of that. This was even like a big tappy metal sound. That's more dull. That's really insane. My slider piece there that we worked on, that's the noisiest piece on the pillar. That's dead, like it should be. Let me try the top on the driver's side. See if there's any difference or not. I don't know. Maybe there's not. Ow! Hit my head. Okay, it's not really different. Almost all of your work here. See, I might work this bottom panel in the driver some other time, because there is a lot of rattles. Right around here is where a lot of your pillar noise is. Anyway, this video's gone on way too long. I'll see you guys.